Absolutely.
Yeah.
And people think of those as...
Well, did we lose you?
Oh,
you're there?
No, okay. I just put it on mute first. I think they had sand on my outside. I didn't want people to actually think there was a VA going. But, oh yeah, people think that things like this, the way it's going to happen is, you know, like I said, virus.
And
it could be, like you said, the bugs. And overseas, people don't understand. It's like, the United States is not the only country with any kind of knowledge of anything. And then that's where a lot of the egotistical minds
don't break.
You know what I mean? It's like, just because a chemical warfare does not have to mean, you know, like the super gas in the air.
No.
And they're going to tighten and they're going to die. Chemical warfare can mean anything.
Expecting
a little tiny bug that can get into, you know,
mosquitoes.
Electrical appliances or, you know, grow bigger or whatever, you know?
Mosquitoes. Look at the funky animals where they've been discovered, you know. I mean, sure, a lot of that was chemical, so, you know, two-headed fish and things going on, but how do we know for sure, you know? They keep saying, yeah, it was toxic or whatever. We don't know what these deformed animals are carrying. You don't know.
No, you don't. And that's exactly what this first segment is about, is like the origins, the beginning. It's like...
Right.
It's not just paranoia anymore, where, like, back in the, you know, 15, 16, 1700s, they would actually put stakes in their dead. That's where that started, because they were afraid that they were going to come back to life.
Right.
Well, that they were going to walk the earth.
Well, look at the Romanian countries. They used to put cages over their graves, so they wouldn't get up. So they couldn't get
out.
Isn't
that crazy?
Yeah.
There was some stuff I read today that I thought was really interesting. In 1810, it was the first time the word zombie was in the dictionary.
Wow, see? Where did that come from?
The very first time, except when it was very first put in there, it didn't mean like man-eating monster crazy thing that came back from the dead. It was actually an African deity.
Oh, well, that's kind of, where would that come from? You know, that had to come from somewhere.
From a book called The History of Brazil.
Yeah, there you
go. And the person who wrote that book used that word, but there was no E at the end.
Ah, okay.
And it meant African deity, which I thought was really, really neat.
But
the first time it was in the dictionary was in 1810.
Wow. Wow, that's even before I thought it would be in there. Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. And let's not forget neurotoxins. There's all kinds of poison out there. That can slow your bodily function so slow that you'd be considered dead. And the poison from Japanese blowfish can do this.
I have heard that. I have heard that a lot of people that they had an allergic reaction and died from a blowfish, they were actually just paralyzed.
Yeah, yeah. That's a neurotoxin.
People actually have been buried alive.
Yep.
Thinking that they were dead from a reaction from the fish.
Right, right.
That is just insane to me. That in this day and age with the technology that we have, that something like that can still happen.
Yeah, we'll get back to the Haitian thing after a bit. That's just crazy. And I use quotes, zombies are aggressive and can be cannibalistic. So, And what about the real rage virus? It turned human in the movie 28 Days Later, the rage virus. In real life,
there is actually something like that out there.
Yes. There's a series of brain disorders that do the same thing.
They said that guy that just got arrested just a few years ago, he was trying to manufacture a rage virus and he was trying to inject it into people. Well, you look at the effects of some drugs like PCP.
Like
that, it makes people just like super strong, and they're like insane and crazy.
You know, I mean, Laura, don't freak out on me here. But look at, they got medicinal marijuana now. Who knows?
Yeah, who knows what they could put in that?
Sure, they could. Yeah, don't freak out, Lori. Yeah, medicinal marijuana. Look out. They could act. You know, why are they making it legal?
You never know.
Yeah, I mean, what a perfect way to do that, if you think about it.
And it really is, or anything. When you look, it's just simple cigarettes.
Yeah.
Over the years,
yes,
what they started putting in those, have you ever looked at the ingredients?
Yes, it is crazy.
I mean, there's thousands of things that are in there, not just a couple. You know what I mean? Like, there's, you know, before I start getting hate mail from people.
Yeah.
Like, yes, I know there's cigarettes out there that have just tobacco, and that's it. But I'm talking about the big names, which I'm not even going to...
Right. Well, yeah, we see it on the commercials. Yeah.
But, yeah, there's, like, thousands of ingredients.
It's like...
So think about how they've stuck that in over the years.
Right.
So think about what they could be sneaking in to things like marijuana, especially if the government ever gets their hands on it, the federal government.
Oh, yeah.
I love it when people say, oh, we want it federally legalized. It's like, no, you don't.
Yeah.
No, you don't.
Yeah, they, you know...
Let me tell you why you don't want it, okay? And in the, you know, the 1920s, 30s, we had speakeasies that were selling, like,
yes,
this moonshine that was, like, insanely strong, that could kill people, but still, it was, like, it was true alcohol, you know?
Yeah, that was...
The government has their hands on, suddenly you've got this watered-down version of God knows what.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. I mean, that was... That stuff would make you blind. Look at the moonshiners, what they used to put in that stuff. Oh, my God. Gasoline, bleach, all kinds of stuff. So, yeah. All kinds of stuff. I mean, the way they used to make it, you know, to cut it and make it stronger. They put all kinds of, oh my God.
Yeah, so think about that. Think about what the federal government has done.
Yes.
To alcohol in cigarettes and things like that, the additives that have been allowed.
Yes.
In these products.
Yep.
That's allowed.
Yeah. I know. I don't know how it can be, but it is.
Yeah, so for people who want marijuana to be federally legalized, think about that one for just a few seconds. If you really want that done, you know?
I mean, what a way to reach millions of people. Easy.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you never know what's going to be in it. You just never know.
Nope.
Water supply. I mean, there's so many ways that a VA could start.
Oh, yeah.
I love it when people laugh. Oh, that can't. And I'm not talking the man eating freaking.
Yeah. Yeah. Although they could be. It's possible.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think they'll actually eat you. They'll just rip you up. But, yeah, who knows?
Let me tell you, if there ever is a VA, I'm hoping for the slow, stupid zombies of, like, The Walking Dead.
Oh, you know it. Yeah.
And, you know, and those type movies, because I don't want the 28 later.
Yeah, no, that, you got that right. That would be crazy. Yeah, look at mad cow disease.
Yeah.
You know, that was an example of it. It attacks the cow's spinal cord and brain, turning it into a mindless attack cow. And when humans eat the meat, when mad cow gets in humans, they call it some kind of disease. The symptoms are changes in walking, hallucinations, stumbling and falling, muscle twitching, rapidly developing delirium, dementia. Yeah. The disease is rare, but maybe not as rare as we think. And they're not in murderous mobs, at least not yet. So, who knows?
So what you're telling me is hamburgers off the menu then?
Yeah. Hungry Chris?
Hamburgers off.
Yeah, oh boy. No. Yes, think about that.
No.
That, I mean...
Keep away from hamburger.
Hungry Chris is like, brains. Yeah. Here, have a hamburger. No thanks. Think all.
Chris,
Think about this. Here's something to think about. If the whole sudden mindless violence idea seems far-fetched, remember this. You are just one brain chemical away from turning into a mindless killing machine, serotonin. Ooh, they've tested it by putting in rats in deathmatch style and watch them turn on each other.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, serotonin. We are one brain chemical away from turning into a mindless killing machine. And they've tested this on rats. They put them in death matches. Isn't that nice?
That's not only sick, man. That's crazy. Am I wrong for wanting to watch one? No, I'm just kidding. just kidding. But that's just crazy, though.
Isn't that's scary?
But what is the purpose of this? This is what I don't understand. Is what is the purpose of this?
I don't know. Why are they doing that? Exactly. Why would you do that? Come on.
Yeah. I mean, why are they, you know, ripping up dog fights and things like that,
right,
and arresting people? These people can do it in the name of science. I don't get that.
Yeah.
Animal cruelty is animal cruelty here, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep. So.
That's crazy.
Yeah. Yep. So
they got to be doing this for a reason, though. You know what I'm
saying? Why are they doing this? Why are they turning these, you know, into death matches to see what happens? Why? All it would take is a disease that destroys the brain's ability to absorb that one chemical. And suddenly, it's a real 28 days later. So, yeah. So, can you imagine mad cow disease getting into our food supply?
Well, you look at something like rabies.
Yeah, there you go.
Like,
yeah.
That's a super rabies from that other one that I just said.
Yeah.
But yeah. Yeah, like a super rabies. What
yeah.
that could do to people.
Yep.
That is just insanity to me. That just to think that something that simple could
yep.
do it. And
yep.
it's like people, but that's the thing, though. People are expecting these slow, like,
yeah, no, not going to happen.
That you can blow up a couple balloons and be like, hey, over here. And then, like, you know, try to eat the balloon.
Yeah.
I just don't think that's how it's going to happen if it does. I mean, you know, I'm definitely not an expert. I mean, I'm an expert on watching these things, but I'm definitely not an expert on the science of it. So,
oh, yeah,
but I just don't see how it's going to be like that.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yep. How do you guys think it's going to happen? What would you think? How do you think it's going to happen? Chris, Lori, how do you think it's going to happen? And say this disease spreads through blood-on-blood contact or saliva or whatever. Now you have a rage-type virus that can be transmitted with a bite. So there you go. Simple.
Right.
It's not
if
as...
If you really think about it, how long is it going to take to get through your system?
Yeah.
I don't think it's going to be like 12 seconds like that one movie, but... I mean, I think that it's definitely, you know, it's not going to take very long.
No, not at all. And it could be as simple as that. So.
Wow. Yeah, everybody definitely put in your input here. Log in, get on the discussion, give us a like on here. And if not, tell us what you think over on our Facebook page at the Planet B.O.B. on Facebook or at the KBLP LLC.
Yep.
Facebook page. Just tell us what you think would start it.
Yeah. What are your opinions?
What is your opinion on what you think would start something like this?
Yeah.
You know, that is just crazy to me. That whole rat thing's freaking me out. That it wants to be eaten by a cat.
Isn't that crazy? Yeah. It's like, but it doesn't even know what it's doing. That's the crazy part. It's like, no, don't do it. And you're just going to walk right up there and get eaten. Chris thinks it's going to be a CIA military operation.
It's very possible. That's if they haven't already done it somewhere.
Yeah. Yep, exactly.
If you really think about it,
they
probably had this technology for a while. If they're letting us know about it, they probably had it for a very long time.
I mean, it's like we always said, the movies and different things, or like you said, in 1810, you know, the word zombie appeared. There's always a base. There's something in it somewhere that we don't know. I mean, did they just come up with this? No, I don't think so. I always said that your myths and legends and things. There's always it had to start with something. So a grain of truth in there somewhere.
Oh, there was a story. I'm trying to remember what show I was watching one day. I'm thinking it was something on sci-fi, but. It was basically about this